This morning in Family Time, the fun rolls on this April school vacation week. And here with us this morning to share a fun activity to try out with the kids, Megan Fischer and Mandy Roach from the Providence Children's Museum. Good morning, ladies.
Good morning.
Nice to have you here. Now, we had to roll up our sleeves for this one because it may get a little messy. You're going to tell us first what's in this. What's in this? Because we're going to do bubble painting.
Yes, bubble painting. So right now we have a bubble solution, which is just a gallon of water with a cup of Dawn dishwashing soap.
Okay.
And we just made that at home. And then we also have tempera paint, which is a very washable paint. So if it gets messy, it won't be hopefully permanent.
All
messy.
Over the place.
And you can also make this bubble paint with food coloring or another type of paint. Tempera, though, because it's washable, is a lot easier for cleanup.
And you were saying before, the food coloring will maybe
it could stain a little bit.
So okay,
be
so you're gonna mix that up while we do that. So I've got the different colors here. We've got some purple, some yellow, a couple of straws, and then where am I gonna put this the paper?
Oh, the paper. I'll explain that just in a second. All so right. We got a half cup of the bubble solution we just made, and then a quarter cup of the tempera paint.
All right.
And I'm gonna just put that right in there.
Mixing your potion up.
Stir it up.
Yes. You gotta make sure, especially with the paint, so it doesn't settle on the bottom. You wanna make sure it's nice and stirred. And then the fun part comes in. If you have a kid who likes to blow bubbles in their milkshake.
Right. See, this is fun.
So you're gonna leave that right there, and then before the bubbles go all the way down, just dab the paper there, and then you get some cool designs right there with the bubbles.
Oh,
and
okay.
If there's still some left on the paper, you can pop them as you go.
And do it that way.
Exactly. Right.
Okay, so I have to do this, like this. Ready?
Oh, there you go. Perfect.
Okay.
Good technique.
And then just dab.
Just dab, exactly.
Dab. Now, let's see. I don't know. The yellow may be a little difficult. Yellow may be a little tough to try. So let me try this purple. Let's just see.
Now, this is a really fun activity.
Here we go.
Might even be good to do it outside.
All right.
Or definitely just make sure you have some newspaper
see,
laid
look
down.
At this.
And
this
the good thing about having multiple colors is you can layer them and mix them.
Oh, all right. So I need to layer. All right. I'm going to switch it up.
Like some purple.
Now, remember, they told me before, don't inhale.
It's true. That would not end
well. Luckily, tempera paint is non-toxic.
Non-toxic also. All right. So while we're doing this, as I'm creating something magnificent, I used the word magnificent a little too quick. It kind of came out a little.
I think it's beautiful. It's nice and saturated.
And you know, if you do have those stubborn bubbles, you can actually blow on it a little bit, and then you get some cool paint splatter effects. Definitely a little bit of abstract art.
Art is in the eye of the beholder. It's kind of, it's kind of an abstract. So what else do you ladies have going on at the Children's Museum?
It's school vacation week, so we have a lot of special activities. Today we have Imagination Playground from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m.
Tell us about that.
Huge blue foam blocks that you can build forts and castles and robots and other interesting structures with. And then tomorrow from 1 to 3 p.m. we have farm animals in our children's garden.
Who doesn't love farm animals,
We will have sheep and teacup pigs and rabbits and chickens and chicks and Rhode Island farmers who will talk to kids about how to make fleece into wool.
Now, you folks are always trying to, do great things for the community and do great things for the kids so the kids can go and enjoy themselves. And it really is one of those fun places that you're always doing, new, exciting stuff.
Absolutely.
And sometimes making a mess.
Oh, that's right. I think being a kid or being, a kid at 46 years old, that's kind of part of the deal, right? So if somebody wants to go to the Providence Children's Museum and do any of this stuff, tell us how we got to go about doing that.
Our website is childrenmuseum.org, and it has our full calendar of activities. We have something special happening every day of the week in addition to our hands-on exhibits.
How much is it to get in?
Admission is $9 per person, and that is beautiful.
Huh? Look
at
this. It's kind of an abstract thing I got going on here. I'm not saying this is going in the Museum of Modern Art, but...
Maybe if you hold it the other way,
Maybe if I hold it.
Now
you can interpret what this is.
No, definitely. The depth, beautiful.
It certainly belongs in a children's museum, at the very least.
What are you saying? Okay, you're also raising money because you also have a great event coming up that you want to talk about too.
So Saturday, April 30th is our Unplugged Gala.
Right.
It's Imagine Empower Play, and it's our largest annual fundraiser and celebrating the importance of play for kids' healthy development, which is what the museum does every day in our activities. But this is how to support important programs for kids and families in need.
In need. Okay. So, and we'll be there. We'll be hosting that event too. So if you want to go have fun, look, I think I did a pretty good job on this, and you can get more information. Get the scoop. scoop on great events and activities happening right here in our area. You can head right over there. Look at that. It's free, folks. It's the Roach Show on the Go app. Be sure to download our free app, Roach Show on the Go.